Hello, I am Krucha Jha. In the course of Global Health Policy and Ethics, today I'd like to present on the policy I have selected for my paper, that is National Water Supply and Sanitation Policy 2014 of Nepal. In order to begin, the context, I'd like to start with the context of the policy. So, establishment of the policy. The policy was made by the Ministry of Urban Development of Nepal and was approved by the Government of Nepal in 2014. History of the policy. Before this policy was made, there were other two policies made in regards with water supply and sanitation, and they were Rural Water Supply and Sanitation Policy 2004 and National Policy for Urban Water Supply and Sanitation 2009. So, in the policy, there was involvement of different stakeholders, and their role in policy process differ, and their strategies were different as well. So, in order to begin, first stakeholder is the Government of Nepal, and the branches of Government of Nepal are MOUD, Ministry of Urban Development, NWSC, Nepal Water Supply Corporation, WSMB, Water Supply Management Board, KUKL, Kathmandu Upateka Khanepani Limited, and DWSS, Department of Water Supply and Sewerage. So the role of Government of Nepal in the policy process was to collaborate with all the other stakeholders, and it was leading the policy. In the same way, the another stakeholder is the media. So media broadcast the issue and pressurize the main actors, and the main actor is the Government of Nepal. So the strategy of the media was to do live programs showing the reality of the issue that people were facing due to poor water supply or no water supply in the rural areas and poor sanitation, and then it broadcasted the issues in the new channels. Similarly, another stakeholders is the civil society. So civil society involved in making the decisions in the policy. Also, it involved from planning to operation and management of services in the policy. Community associations, INGOs, NGOs that include VDC, municipality, WSA, WSC, UNDP are also the stakeholders in the policy. So these help in the implementation of the policy as well. So they help in the mobilizing communities to assess and monitor the sustainability of the projects and adequate tariff for sustainable service delivery. Similarly, the main and the very important stakeholder is RWSSFDB. It is Rural Water Supply and Sanitation Fund Board. And this was the fund board of the project in the projects in the policy, and to, its strategy was to fund the projects, and it was the permanent agency of the government to provide financial grant and implement assistance through NGOs. Looking at the stakeholders, we need to identify their power in the policy. So I have categorized their power in a hierarchy system. So if we take a pyramid, so on the top of the pyramid, the highest power is with the Government of Nepal and its branches such as MOUD and WSC and so on, and the RWSSFDB, that is the fund board of the policy. The second column in the pyramid lies the community association, INGOs, NGOs, that helped in the implementation of the policy. Their power were less than the Government of Nepal. Third is the media. So media has less power, and but it influenced a lot in the project because it was pressurizing the upper powers or the stakeholder with the highest powers. Similarly, civil society has the least power, but it also has a very little influence in the policy in some manner, and So civil society is helped in the volunteering of the implementation of the project, and then but they were the one who were benefited the highest. So now I'd like to talk about the content in the policy. So the main contents of the policy are: reduce urban and rural poverty by ensuring equitable socio-economic development, improve health and the quality of life of the people, protect environment through the provision of sustainable water supply and sanitation services. Process of the policy. What was the process, the way policy was made? So Millennium Development Goals had provided a solid footing for Nepal's government to set higher targets. Millennium Development Goals was the highest priority, so the policy was made with the by putting it into the consideration. Also, meeting was held between the government officials and the NGOs and the INGOs officers regarding the making of the policy and the implementation of the policy. As stated earlier, the policy was proposed by the Ministry of Urban Development of Nepal. RWSS-FDB was made the permanent agency of the government to provide financial grants to all the projects in the policy. There are ethical concerns in the policy. So, actions versus consequences. In the policy, there were some statements made, but the outcomes were not exactly the same. That is what actions versus consequences is. For example, the aim of the policy is to protect surface and groundwaters from wastewater pollution, but there has been no explanation of how it will be done. Also, the policy was very generalized. There were no objectives regarding the geographical structure and climate changes of Nepal. Since Nepal is divided into three parts, mountains, hills and plain region, the policy should have been a little different for each of the geographical structure. Also, considering the climate changes of Nepal, that includes the global warming and the natural disasters such as earthquake, flood and landslide that Nepal has to face every year, the policy should be very considered about the climate changes in Nepal. So my recommendations for the policy would be: the policy should be made in regards with the geographical structure of Nepal and the climate changes, as I explained earlier. Similarly, government should keep meeting with NGOs and INGOs time and again and put report of what's happening in the implementation of the policy so that the success rate can be assumed. Also, more investment should be done in ill health and medical treatment, as most of the people in Nepal are below poverty line, so they go through a lot of health problems. So investment is really important in case of ill health and medical treatment. Strict rules and regulations should be made to prevent misuse of water and corruption in implementing the policy. Also, corruption is really high in Nepal, so while implementing the policy, the rules and regulations should be very strict so that people won't be doing corruption, and also while they are supplying the water, they should also be considered about the people misusing the water, so that in the future, the future generations won't go in the shortage of water. Awareness programs are really important, so they should be organized for people about sanitation, waterborne diseases, in order to uplift their quality of life. These are the references for the presentations that I have made. And thank you so much for listening. Have a good time. Thank you.